Hi, folks. We're talking about bond projects again. I'm Chris Hoy. I'm the mayor of Salem, and I'm here today at Gear Park with Rob Romanek, the parks planning manager. So today we're trying to highlight some of the new things we're going to be able to do with the bond coming up, and this will be $28.4 million worth of investments into our park system. How do you, when you think about that number, what does that mean to you?
Oh, it makes me really excited. I'm really happy that we're investing in our parks here in Salem, both making our parks last longer, the ones we have, but also providing some new facilities to hit out some of the highest needs that we know we have in the community. So I'm really excited about this package of projects that we have in this money.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, this is the largest infusion of cash ever into parks in Salem, is that right?
That is correct.
Yeah, it's so exciting. Normally we can do a lot of planning and things, and we have great plans for our park property, but then we never have the money to actually put those plans in place. So I know that recently you went through a major planning process here at Gear Park with the neighbor associations and the community, and came up with a great master plan for this park. And so now you're actually going to be able to see it built out. So tell us a little bit about some of the amenities coming to Gear Park.
Yeah, absolutely. So here at Gear Park, coming right out of that master plan update, we are going to see a dog park installed.
Yes.
Here at Gear. It's going to include a small dog or a timid dog area. And so these two separate areas will be fenced off, and it will have a lot of amenities. Right next to that dog park, we're going to construct a new shelter, a picnic shelter for family and small community gatherings that will be reservable. And then the other big investment that's going to happen here at Gear is that we're going to completely renovate the four existing fields. So here at Gear, we have two baseball fields and we have two soccer fields. So they have been serving residents of Salem for almost 20 years, and to extend their life, make sure we get the most out of them, we're going to really kind of refresh them, redo the irrigation, redo the turf, look at ways to maximize the use of them, both the season use, but also the life of those fields.
Yeah, this is going to be a great, great new asset for folks here in East Salem, where I live, to be able to have a dog park that, you know, closer to our homes. So I'm so excited about what's happening at Gear Park. Let's talk for a minute about some of the other things that are coming to some of our other parks.
Yeah, there's a second dog park that we've developed in South Salem at a property we own in the former Fairview Training Center area. There are a number of other picnic shelters and field renovations that we'll be doing. And we'll also be, this is really popular to some people, but we're going to be rehabbing and adding some new restrooms into our park system at some of our more popular parks.
Good. Yeah, there are some that are, some of our restroom facilities are quite old and really in need of replacement, and so that's exciting. Talk to us a little bit about some of the courts and things. We talk a lot about pickleball these days. Tell us a little bit about some of those projects.
Yeah, so we'll be renovating some existing sports courts, primarily that we have in our neighborhood parks, that have just, they've served us well for a long time, but they need to be redone, and that's an opportunity to rethink about what type of uses they support. So you mentioned pickleball. I expect that will be popular. You might be looking at some new uses like futsal or a paved surface for a small soccer play. I'm really excited about that. We're also going to be renovating some play structures, playgrounds, about 10 of them actually with this bond measure, which I'm really excited about. Again, to make sure those are safe and they're modern and available for our residents.
I also just think it's important that we mention, since we were talking about dog parks and some of the upgrades, we are actually going to be paving the parking lot out at the dog park at Minto Brown. Is that correct?
That's correct. So we call parking lot number two, which is a trailhead access parking lot, but also the dog park parking lot, will be paved through this money. And also what we call parking lot number one, which is the one at the end of the road closest to the river, it's also going to be renovated through this measure.
And I think we call it parking lot number two because that's about how many feet the holes are in the winter that get dug in from all the traffic out there. So that's so exciting. That's going to be, the thing is about, it's not just going to be better for the users, but it's going to be better for the ongoing cost of the city, because we're every year having to go out and fix that gravel lot because it just gets so, the holes get so deep. And so that's really exciting to be putting some long-term fixes in place there. What else should we be talking about when it comes to the bond projects with the parks?
Well, I think it's important to understand that some of these projects have been funded, but we don't know the details yet. And so we're going to be asking for some community input as we implement these projects over a 10-year period. There'll be occasions where we'll be asking for input to help us envision what those slightly different or those renovated facilities are going to look like.
Well, that's fantastic. Thank you for joining me today on this really blustery January day out here at Gear Park. For more information, be sure and check out the city's website, cityofsalem.net/2022bond.